Hello and welcome to another episode of Medicine Can Be Easy. In today's episode, we are going to talk about the extracellular and intracellular fluid and the internal environment. You've probably already heard that there's a lot of water in our organism, but how much actually? Well, for an adult, 60% of the body is formed by fluid, or to be more precise, by a water solution with ions and other substances. But there are two important factors that we need to consider. The first one is age, and the second one is the presence of fat tissue. Let's start with age. When you're born, 80% of your body is fluid, and this number slowly decreases to about 50% when you're older than 80. There's also a slight difference based on sex, so men have more water than women. As I said, the second factor is fat. And here it's very simple. The more fat you have, the less water. We can divide the fluid in our body into two compartments, intracellular and extracellular fluid. Intra means inside, and extra means outside. So we can simply say that intracellular fluid is the fluid that is inside the cells, and extracellular fluid is the fluid that is outside the cells. The extracellular fluid can be further divided into two compartments, interstitial fluid and intravascular fluid. Again, intra means inside, and inter means between. So, intravascular fluid is the fluid that is inside the blood vessels, so we're talking about plasma, and interstitial fluid is the fluid that is around the cells in the tissue, it surrounds them. Now, let's quickly say a few things about the extracellular fluid. The extracellular fluid is in constant motion. It circulates in the blood. It diffuses through the capillary walls to the tissue fluid, and it contains ions and nutrients that cells need in order to live. For that reason, it is sometimes referred to as milieu intérieur, which means internal environment, and this is a term which was first used by the French physiologist Claude Bernard. Now that we have divided fluid into two compartments, we need to calculate how big each compartment is. So, intracellular fluid forms 40% of body weight and 2/3 of all the water there is in the organism. For the extracellular fluid, it's 20% of body weight and 1/3 of all the water in the organism. 75% of extracellular fluid is formed by interstitial fluid and 25% by intravascular fluid. Interstitial fluid represents 15% of body weight and intravascular fluid 5% of body weight. Now that you understand this, we can do a very simple example of how to calculate all the compartments in our body. So let's imagine a patient whose body weight is 70 kilograms. We know that 60% of the body is formed by water, so that is 42 liters. Intracellular fluid forms 2/3 of all the water, that is 28 liters, and extracellular fluid forms 1/3 of all the water, that is 14 liters. Now we need to further divide these 14 liters into two compartments. Interstitial fluid, which is 75% of the extracellular fluid, so that's 10.5 liters, and intravascular fluid, which is 25% of the extracellular fluid, so that means 3.5 liters. Okay? Good. So I hope that this video helped you to understand the basic difference between the extracellular and intracellular fluid. If you like this video, please do subscribe. We are looking forward to seeing you next time. And please don't forget that medicine can be easy.